A four-lane highway through the mountains of Pennsylvania? Yeah, this can only be one place, and that is the Pennsylvania Turnpike. And I've traveled on this stretch of it as a kid. But one day, this chunk of road, about 10 miles of the turnpike, suddenly disappeared. Let's go meet up with my Pennsylvanian friend, Alann Schmidt, and find out just what the heck's going on here on the Lost Highway on this episode of Museum of America.
I'm a rolling stone, all alone and long, for a life of sin I have paid the cost. When I pass by, all the people say, just another guy on the lost highway, just a deck of cards.
We're just a few miles from Breezewood, Pennsylvania, one of the busiest intersections in any highway in America. Pennsylvania Turnpike zooms right across the hills just to our east. And most of those people traveling to and fro don't realize they are going right past one of the most unique, special places, unlike none in the world. And that is here on the abandoned section of the Turnpike, the Lost Highway. From the early days of Pennsylvania, the challenge always was in getting goods and people from east to west, finding a way across the large mountain ranges here in central Pennsylvania. Railroads were big business in the early days and really were the only way to get across. So much so, even though there was already the established Pennsylvania Railroad, in 1880s William Vanderbilt decided he would make a competing railroad, the South Pennsylvania Railroad. Workmen got started on a hugely ambitious project, making a way all the way across southern Pennsylvania. They've started the drilling of 9 different tunnels into the hills and starting to level off right away all across the country. But as costs continued to mount, Vanderbilt decided against the project and was eventually just abandoned. Years and years passed, no one thought much about that route until in the 1930s, when Pennsylvania officials were trying to decide whether or not to make a large highway across their state, someone thought, hey, we could still use that same route that they already prepared. The state bought that land and those right-of-ways that Vanderbilt had used, brought in work parties, and got started. And in 1940, the Pennsylvania Turnpike opened.
Time-saving superhighways, Futurama's free-flowing channels of concrete and steel.
It would be the nation's first superhighway, the highway to the future, the highway of dreams, and mostly known as the Tunnel Highway. Those mountains in the distance would have made travel across Pennsylvania very difficult in the days before the turnpike. But now, with the Dream Highway, motorists didn't have any of that to worry about. There was no cross traffic at towns, there were no steep hills, no sharp curves, nothing to slow you down. Except all of those tunnels. In each of those tunnels, the four-lane highway would condense down into just 2 lanes. So as more and more traffic started to use the road, big bottlenecks would start to appear at those tunnels. More delays means more problems. Not what we're for here on the highway to the future. Finally, in the late 60s, the Turnpike Commission decided to build parallel tunnels to alleviate the traffic problems, except here near Breezewood, where they simply rerouted the road up over the ridge and bypassed the Sidling Hill and Rays Hill tunnels and the road in between them. From 1968 on, this area would be abandoned, forgotten,
lost.
It's really kind of an eerie sense here on the turnpike, and especially here at these tunnels as they've been abandoned. No one around. I kind of feel like Jason Robards here in The Day After, as it is kind of post-apocalyptic around and nobody here, but yet these modern facilities around. I'm shocked George Romero's never used this tunnel for his latest zombie movie. I think it would be perfect. Silent Hill Tunnel is the longest ever on the turnpike, over a mile and a quarter long. It is very dark and very scary inside. Let's take a look. Someone say, zombie.
Hey, Alan, I found a light switch. Guess he didn't pay the bill.
For the last 40 years, this section of the turnpike has been used for several research projects, like in the development of rumble strips, or for military training, or several other temporary uses. But mostly, it's just continued to erode away. Finally, in 2001, the state sold the road to the Southern Alleghenies Conservancy for development as a hiking and biking trail. But for now, the road is simply a unique combination of transportation history and beautiful wilderness, a literal road to nowhere.
Hey, Alan.
Yeah?
What's the deal here? We got obviously what was a parking lot. Back here in these trees, I distinctly saw a little patch of what is very clearly ceramic bathroom tiles right on the forest floor. What's that?
Well, you know, Manny, as a youngster, it's very possible you have been here before, because this is the site of the Cove Valley Service Plaza.
The old Service Plaza, the old Howard Johnson's.
This was a Howard Johnson's. This was a Service Plaza serving this end of the turnpike before you went through these tunnels. When this section was closed, they tore down the building, and all we have left is where these trees have grown up. You can see the parking lot around, and in the middle, where they tore that away, the trees have gone, are gone, and the Sidling Hill Plaza, which serves both sides, was the first to do that, replace this just on the other side of the road.
All right, here it was, an old Howard Johnson's, and currently serving no flavors. Hey, Alan, I just want to thank you for showing my viewers that once again there are some really cool places out here in the Museum of America.
I just think the Lost Highway and the abandoned turnpike is really one of the more special things you're ever going to find tucked away here in the woods. Not going to be anything like this in the world. Come out, go for a bike ride, go for a hike, see some really cool things. Spend the day on the Lost Highway.
Miss Rudolph said, are you sorrow bound? It's my advice, are you cursed today? You started rolling down.